Am I clearly audible to you? And is the screen clearly visible to you? Okay. So today we are directly discussing the question, the remaining question. Already the five questions are there that we discussed, right? So rest of the question we are discussing now. Let me see how many participants are there. Yet only 9 students are there. We'll wait for 2 minutes and then we'll start the session, okay? Hope you are reading the content, right? Are you reading the content or not? Kingdom Planty. Not only that topic, already the weightage by topics are given in front of you. See, just 1 minute. This is the weightage of the topics which is already given to you, right? Now you decide how much time and how much weightage is given to that topic, particular topic, and which topics are there which are important as per the exam point of view, right? Okay, so most important topic, genetics and biotechnology, these are the two different units. The only different units ahead, but on that two units, almost 15 question asked, means 16 marks questions are there on it, right? So this topic, it is there, you have to read, you have to solve the question on the priority. Second topic, it is there for grade 12 student, means batch 2020. These two topics are new to you, but the student who are there in batch 2021, it's necessary to them to practice more and more question. And for 22 batch, need to read the topic if you are having the NCERT. If not, the topics which are there in grade 11, you have to read it. Okay. Okay, let's start the session with the question. Already first 5 questions are done. Right now we are there on question number 6. The question, it is very easy. Ask in NEET 2017. So see the question which is there in front of you. Select the mismatch. Okay. So 3 options are there. These options are correct. Only one option is there that is wrong. So cycas, dioecious, salvinia, heterosporous, equisetum, homosporous, and pinus dioecious. Before tell means accepting the answer from your side, tell me what is dioecious. Here 3 new words are there. Dioecious means what? Simply unmute yourself and give the answer. Simple question ahe, asked in NEET 2017. What do you mean by dioecious? Right, absolutely correct, Manu. Means male and female plants are different, right? Now 2 different words are there, heterosporous and homosporous. Heterosporous and homosporous. Yes, what is heterosporous and homosporous? Right, Zia, that is about the dioecious. Male and female plants are separate. Is it correct? What is heterosporous and homosporous? Yes. Heterosporous and homosporous. Yes. Right, male and female reproductive organs that individually they are said to be a dioecious. Heterosporous and homosporous means, heterosporous means presence of 2 different kinds of spores, and homosporous means all the spores are looking same. So tell me which option is showing mismatch.
Okay, D, finest. Okay, rest of the member. I got the answer from Abdul. Rest of the members. Okay. Rest of the member. I want the answer from everyone. And in between the session, you have to on your screen for just 10 minutes. Okay. Okay. Okay, so I got the answer from Siddesh and Shweta. Rest of the members, kindly participate. If you don't know the answer, simply say that this question is new to you. Okay. Yes. Yes. Okay. Tell me why this option it is wrong. Okay, it is a hetero what? Here the question is about dioecious or monoecious. Right. So see why the answer is correct. It is mismatched. Because finest, in the finest, male and female are there. They are present on the same plant. They are not dioecious. Finest is a monoecious. Monoecious is a concept where male and female reproductive gametes are present on same plant, right? Are you getting it now? See, cycas. Cycas is a gymnosperm plant. It is a dioecious. Male and female cycas plants are separate. Okay, in the academy itself, you are observing it. Both are heteroscorers, but see here the question it is what is select the mismatch in front of cycas and pinus. What is given? You have to find out the mismatch. Are you getting the question, Sumaya? Cycas dash dioecious means this is the pair, this is the matching. Is it correct? Yes, it is correct because cycas, male and female plants are present separately or they born separately. Male cycas and female cycas, their strobili, their cones are separate, right? So this option is correct. Now, Salvinia. Salvinia is an aquatic pteridophytic plant. Okay. Salvinia is a pteridophyte. Its strobili means its reproductive part. It produces two different kinds of spores. That's why this option is also correct. Equisetum. Equisetum is again. And what is equisetum? Is it in algae, pteridophyte, gymnosperm or angiosperm? So equisetum is also pteridophyte. Okay. So it is homosporous. It produces only one kind of spores. But in case of a pinus, male and female plants are not separate. Male and female reproductive organs, they are present on the same body. Getting it? Okay, getting it? So lastly, getting the answer of the question. So shall we move for the next one? Okay, now see the next question number 7. So see it there on your screen. Again, it is very simple question. It is asked in NEET 2017. Zygotic meiosis is a characteristic feature of, or it is a characteristic of. See question number 7. Zygotic meiosis is characteristic feature of. See Fucus, Funaria, Chlamydomonas and Merkantia. So out of the following plants, which one is showing a zygotic meiosis? means zygotic meiosis means what? The zygote, it divides meiotically. Asa konta plant ahe? Fucus, Funaria, Chlamydomonas and Merkantia. See fucus, fucus is algae, Funaria, Funaria is a bryophytic plant. Okay, so we got two answers, C and D. Chlamydomonas is algae, Merkantia is a bryophytic plant. Okay, I got the answer from Diya, Siddesh, Sumaya. Okay. Aditya, then Bhakti, Ganesh, Hamad, Muazzam, Pratiksha, Shweta. Kindly participate in the conversation. Zygotic meiosis. See, zygotic meiosis means the zygote is formed or zygote is divided by the meiosis. Okay. So, answer of Shweta is first, fucus, algae. So, we got three different answers. Fucus, then Chlamydomonas and Merkantia. Is there any other student with any other option? Okay. I want the answer from everyone. Okay. So let me tell you the correct answer of this. So the correct answer is the Chlamydomonas. So Chlamydomonas is an algae where zygote divides meiotically, right? So the correct answer is zygotic meiosis is observed in Chlamydomonas. This Chlamydomonas shows the plantic type of life cycle. So tell me, do you know about the life cycle? Okay, right, Bhakti? Life cycle in plants, haplontic, diplontic, haplodiplontic, these are the types of life cycle. So what do you mean by haplontic, diplontic and haplodiplontic? Yes. Haplontic, diplontic and haplodiplontic. It is depending upon the sporophyte and gametophyte. So haplontic, in case of a haplontic type of life cycle, sporophyte and gametophyte, they remain haploid, right? Then in case of a diplontic type of life cycle, sporophytic and gametophytic phase, they show diploid structure, and in haplodiplontic case, they show vice versa. Okay, means haploid and diploid phases are observed in them. Okay. Getting the answer of question number 7. All of you getting the answer of question number 7. Okay, can we move for the next one? See, whatever the question we are discussing, these are the most recently asked question. Now, the next question. See, it's based on the life cycle only. Already we discussed it. Diplontic, haplodiplontic. Now, for this, या क्वेश्चन चा आंसर माहित असण्यासाठी तुम्हाला जे प्लांट तुमच्या समोर दिलेले आहेत, फॉर एक्झाम्पल एक्टोकार्पस आणि फ्युकस, ते कोणत्या ग्रुप मध्ये येतात हे माहिती असणं फार गरजेचं आहे. मीन्स एक्टोकार्पस इज बिलॉंगिंग टू विच ग्रुप अँड फ्युकस इज बिलॉंगिंग टू विच ग्रुप, राईट? सो सी, एक्टोकार्पस अँड फ्युकस, द लाईफ सायकल इन दॅम, दे आर रिस्पेक्टिव्हली डिप्लॉन्टिक, हॅप्लोडिप्लॉन्टिक, हॅप्लोडिप्लॉन्टिक अँड डिप्लॉन्टिक, हॅप्लोडिप्लॉन्टिक अँड हॅप्लॉन्टिक, haplontic and diplontic. For grade 11, the batch 2022, this concept is new. You have to read the content for the better understanding. You have to know the plant, right, Shweta? Means I got the answer from Shweta that option D. Okay, I got the answer from Ganesh, Abdul, and Rosa. All they are having option B as their answer. Rest of the member, okay, Bhakti is with the same option, option B. Same about the Siddhesh. Okay, same about Muazzam. Okay, can you explain me why your option B is correct? And Ganesh? Or Shweta? Sorry, Shweta, can you explain me why the answer B is correct? Yes. Ectocarpus. Ectocarpus is it pterophyte? Is it correct? Ectocarpus is the pterophytic plant. Manav. Yes, it is a brown algae. Okay, ectocarpus is the algae, not a pterophyte. Not about fucus. Am I clearly audible to you now? By the way, my video is off because of network issue only. Am I clearly audible to you now? Yes, all of you. Am I clearly audible? Okay, so ectocarpus and fucus, those both are algae, right? Ectocarpus shows haploidic type of life cycle, but the fucus, it shows diploidic type of life cycle, right? Ectocarpus is haplodiploidic and fucus is diploidic type of life cycle. Means option B is correct for this question, Shweta. Kindly correct yourself. See, ectocarpus shows haplodiploidic type of life cycle and fucus, it shows diploidic type of life cycle. So getting the answer of it, for this thing you need a multiple reading of the textbook, that is NCERT. Okay, now next one, question number 9. Okay, this question, it is asked in 2016. Now it is based on your general knowledge. Conifers are adapted to tolerate extreme environmental conditions because of. Conifers means the cone-bearing plants, the plants which are having a cone-like appearance. It might be about the Araucaria. Many times I gave the example in the classroom also, because this there are two plants of Araucaria in front of your, the window that you are sitting in that class, right? So conifers, the cone-bearing plants, they are adapted for living in extreme environmental condition because of. Okay, so I got the answer from everyone, that is the C. That is, they are having a thick cuticle. Why option A is wrong? Broad, hardy leaves. Why this option is wrong? Which kind of leaf is present in conifers or gymnosperm? Conifers means what? Gymnosperm. Absolutely correct, Siddhesh. These are showing a needle-like leaf. So the leaves are not broad. The leaves are needle-like. They are very small. So that's why the first option is wrong. Then superficial stomata. What do you mean by super? Right, Zia? Superficial stomata. Superficial stomata means what? Yes, stomata are present only on the upper side. Then the last one, presence of vessel. If gymnosperm shows the presence of vessel, see, it's about the vascular tissue. Which tissue is absent in the gymnosperm and which tissue is present in the gymnosperm? Okay. Conifers, gymnosperm shows the presence of vessel. Vessel is the characteristic feature of which group? Yes. No, vessel is not present. So, the only one option it is that it has a thick cuticle. So, the plants are included in the gymnosperm. Yes, xylem vessel is absent. Consisting of two tubes and companion cell. It consisting of two tubes and companion cell. So their characteristic feature is that they are not having a broad hardy leaf, but they are having a needle-like leaf. Stomata are not superficial. Stomata are sunken. Okay, sunken stomata. These are the characteristic feature of xerophytic plants. Right? And conifers are referred to be a xerophytic plant. So for living an extreme environmental condition, they are having a thick cuticle. Sunken means what? See, the stomata, they never open. Okay, sunken stomata means the stomata they get never open to stay in the particular environment. Okay, sunken stomata mostly is present in the xerophytic plant, in the desert plant. In this case, the stomata they open during the night, not at the daytime, to survive in the particular environment. Getting it? Getting the answer of this question? Okay, so moving to the next question. Now, find out the wrong statement among the following. So, see the four statements are there in front of you. The first one. We have to find out the wrong one. Three are correct. Algae increases the level of dissolved oxygen in the immediate environment. Okay, so see, algae, they are plants. Are they dissolving the oxygen in the environment? Second, algae is obtained from red algae and carrageenan from brown algae. Then, agar-agar, which is a solidifying agent used in the tissue culture. Agar-agar is obtained from gelidium and gracilaria. Laminaria and sargassum are used as a food. So, which one is most correct statement among the following? The first one is the correct, according to you. B. Correct statement. I am asking you the correct statement. Okay, D is correct. Absolutely correct. D is correct. Even A is correct. Okay. Laminaria and sargassum, these are said to be a, they are useful or edible algae. Sargassum C and laminaria. Sargassum and laminaria, they are used as a food. Absolutely correct, Ganesh. Yes, Sweta. Option C is also correct. Agar agar is obtained from gelidium and gracilaria. As I already told you, agar agar is a solidifying agent. It is obtained from red algae, gelidium and gracilaria. These two statements are correct. Even option A is also correct. Algae increases the level of dissolved oxygen in the immediate environment. As they are plants, they are performing the photosynthesis. The product of photosynthesis is oxygen. So that's why the first statement is also correct. Means which statement is wrong now? Which option is correct? Which is a wrong statement? Option B. Can you tell me why the option B is wrong? What is the correct statement then? Right, option B is wrong. Why? Then what is the correct statement for the same? Yes, Manu. Right, absolutely correct. So the first one, alginine is obtained from brown algae and carrageenan is obtained from red algae. So it's the opposite, right? So that's why option B is wrong. All of you getting it?
Okay.
So the B option it is wrong. Now the next one. Now the question is asked in NEET 1 2016. So now why it is 1 and 2? There are some question which is asked in NEET 2nd 2016. That time two attempts are done as the first paper it is leaked. Okay, the first paper it is leaked. That's why that exam it is taken again.
So now see, you have to find out the correct statement. Sesquia is one of the tallest tree. The leaves of gymnosperms are not adapted to the extreme climate. Right now only you solve this question. So tell me whether it is correct or wrong. Gymnosperm have both homospores and heterospores. Salvinia, Gingko, and Pinus are gymnosperm. You have to find out the correct statement. Even again, I am requesting everyone to on your camera for attendance purpose. Okay, option A is correct. Rest of the member. Rest of the members. So many questions are there that we have to for our discussion. Okay. We are right now just only on question number 11. As the questions you solve, that much benefits you will get. Okay. Is it beneficial? Yes. Is the sessions are beneficial? Okay, so we got two answers. Option A and C. Okay, so most of you are, the answer is C. Okay, so except Siddesh, rest of you are, your answer is option C. So tell me why statement D is wrong. Okay, C is wrong. Okay, then what is the correct answer, Shweta? What is the correct answer? Okay. According to the Shweta, gymnosperm is heterosporous only producing two kinds of spores. Okay. So why statement D is wrong? See, D and B, these two statements are absolutely wrong. B, see, the leaves of gymnosperms are not adapted to extreme climate. As in the previous questions only we discussed it, gymnosperm living or adapted for living in the extreme environmental condition, for that they are having a needle like leaf. So this option is absolutely wrong. It's not correct. Option D, Salvinia, Ginkgo, and Pinus are gymnosperm. So why that statement is wrong? Is Salvinia is a gymnospermic plant? Okay. Okay, Sumaya. No, then Salvinia is included in which group? B statement is wrong, D statement is wrong. Salvinia is included in which group? C, Salvinia is aquatic pteridophyte. Ginkgo, is it a gymnosperm or pteridophyte? Salvinia is a pteridophytic plant. That means the statement is wrong. What about Ginkgo biloba and Pinus? Okay, that two options are wrong. Now see question A and C. Okay, they are gymnosperm, right? Now A and C, see the statement C. Gymnosperm have both homospores and heterospores.
So see here, gymnosperms are there. These gymnospermic plants, these are heterosporous. It produces two different kinds of spores. Might be used to read about this, homospores and heterospores. Okay, gymnosperms are producing two kinds of spores. So they are heterosporous. They are not homosporous. So option C is also correct. And the correct statement is the first one. That is the tallest gymnospermic plant. Okay, so getting the answer? All of you getting the answer of this question? Side by side, you may on your cameras. Aarti ma'am is there. She will mark your attendance. Okay. For the attendance point of view, just open the camera. Okay, now we are moving to the next question, question number 12. This is very simple question. I want the answer from all the students, mostly the students who are there in 2021 batch. In bryophytes and pteridophytes, transport of male gametes requires birds, water, insect, and bin. Okay, so I got the answer from Shweta and Mano. Rest of the students. In bryophytes and pteridophytes, transport of male gametes required. Yes. In bryophytes and pteridophytes, transport of male gametes required. Okay, I got the answer from Siddesh and Mohitam. Rest of the student. So will you explain me why the answer water is correct, because it is the correct one. Okay, Sumaya. Why the answer is water? Right, Aditya. Yes, why option B is correct? Right, because the water, with the help of water, the sperms of bryophytes and pteridophytes, they are transferred as they are having a flagella. Hence, they require supply of water to reach till the archegonia. Okay, so sperm of bryophytes and pteridophytes are flagellated. Hence, they require an external supply of water to reach till archegonia. Okay, so answer B is correct for it. Now, next one, question number 13. See, this question is based on the reserve food material in algae. So, coming to the next question. See, this question, it is asked in NEET 2015, which is cancelled. So, the question is, which of the following statement is wrong? So, see, mannitol is stored in rhodophyce, means it is reserve food material in rhodophyce. Algae and carrageenan are the products of algae. Agar-agar is obtained from Gelidium and Gracilaria. Chlorella and spirulina are used as a space food. Okay, Mano. So, according to Mano, the answer is A. This is a very simple question. See, such questions are asked from this topic. So, this topic is very easy. You need to clear your concept, need to know about the plants. For that, you have to search the plants on the net. Because right now, all the plants are not there in front of you. So, better understanding the plants, you need to observe the plants through its picture from the internet. Okay. Okay, Shweta. So is option C and D is correct? Already that statement is discussed in previous question, that agar agar is obtained from Gelidium and Gracilaria. Okay, chlorella and spirulina. If both the algae are used in the space research, yes, so both algae are used, and algae and carrageenan that we already discussed, these are the products of algae. So option A is wrong. Why option A is wrong? Because mannitol is the reserve food material in Phaeophyceae, not Rhodophyceae. What is the reserve food material in Rhodophyceae? Yes, right, Siddhesh. Mannitol or laminarian starch. This is the reserve food material in Phaeophyceae, not Rhodophyceae. Then what is the reserve food material in Rhodophyceae? Yes, it is the fluorodiene starch. Fluorodiene starch is the reserve food material in algae, right? Now, next one. Moving to the next question. Question number 14. In which of the following, gametophyte is not independent free living? This is again asked from the 2015, the exam which is cancelled. In which of the following, gametophyte is not independent free living? Pteryl, Pinus, Funaria, Mercantia. Means what? It is dependent upon the gametophyte. It is a special kind of group. Gymnosperm, pteridophyte, angiosperm, algae, and bryophyte. Out of which this is the one group it is there. That male and female gametophyte do not have independent or free living existence. They are present within the same sporophyte. Okay, so the group gymnosperm, absolutely correct. In the gymnosperm, male and female are not depend upon each other. They are living in the same thing. So out of Pteryl, Pinus, Funaria, and Mercantia, which is a gymnospermic plant. Right, absolutely correct. So answer is Pinus, as in the gymnospermic plant. Okay, what is Pteryl? Pteryl is included in which group? Right, option B is correct for it. So what is Pteryl? Pteryl is included in which group? Right, Bhakti. Pteryl is included in which group? Yes, it is a pteridophyte. Then Funaria. Funaria. What about the Funaria? It's a bryophytic plant. Mercantia. Mercantia. Right, it is again a bryophytic plant. All of you getting the answer of this question. Why? Because in gymnosperm, right, Ganesh? Because in gymnosperm, male and female gametes, they are not depend upon. They are not independently there in the existence. They are found in the one sporangium only. So the correct answer is Pinus. So moving to the next question. See, question number 15. It is again asked in NEET 2015, which is cancelled. See, A to E, the statements are given to you. You have to find out the correct statement from the above. So see the first statement, mosses and lichen. Mosses means bryophytes. Mosses and lichens are the first organism to colonize a bare rock. Then Selaginella is a homosporous pteridophyte. Sporulide roots in cycles have VAM. VAM means vesicular, herbicular, mycorrhizae.
main plant body in bryophytes is the gametophytic, whereas in pteridophytes it is sporophytic. And E statement, in gymnosperm, male and female gametophyte are present within a sporangia located on sporophyte. So out of this five statement, which three statements are correct? Okay, I got the answer from Zia. Rest of the members, okay, answer from Bhakti. Okay, Zia, according to you, the answer is C. Okay, Manav's answer is A. Same answer is Shweta. Okay, Siddesh. So tell me, is the first statement it is correct? Mosses and lichens are the first organism to colonize the bare rock. Is it correct? Yes. You see here two options, B and D are wrong. First statement is correct. Now tell me, Selaginella is a homosporous pteridophyte. Is Selaginella is a homosporous pteridophyte? No, it produces two different kinds of spore. So the statement is wrong. Now, third one, sporuloid root in cycas have VAM. Is it correct? VAM means vesicular herbicular mycorrhizae. Is it having V vesicular herbicular mycorrhizae? Right. Then what it have? What it has? The coralloid root of cycas, what it is having? Which group it is having? Coralloid roots of cycas having. These are having blue-green algae, right? These are having a blue-green algae, corolla roots of cycas. They show the presence of blue-green algae like nostoc, anabena, okay? And VAM forms, yes, it's showing a cyanobacter, and VAM, they are mostly there in the association with the fungus, right? So C statement is wrong. Tell me about D. Main plant body in bryophyte is gametophytic, whereas pteridophyte is sporophytic. Is this statement is correct? If the option is wrong, then what will be your option answer? Correct answer is A, because C is wrong, right? So option D, main plant body of bryophyte is gametophytic, while pteridophyte is sporophytic. And the last statement, in gymnosperm, male and female gametes are present within the sporangia. That's the statement we already discussed in the previous question, right? They are not living independent. So that statement. Okay.
Up to this means almost we discussed 10 questions within 45 minutes. In that question, is there any doubt? Yes, in that question, is there any doubt? If not, we will wait we'll stop for today's session, or we will continue for next 5 questions. It's up to you. If you want to continue the session, we will continue it for the next 2 to 3 questions. No other, we will stop. Yes. Okay, Shweta wants to continue. Rest of the member, it's upon you only. It's not a compulsory to everyone. Means it is not compulsorily. By the way, we are having one more session. Okay, Aditya. Rest of the member. Okay, Bhakti. Okay.
Okay, so we are going with the majority. We will discuss the next question. Question number 16, we are discussing only four questions. Okay. फक्त चार क्वेश्चन आपण 10 मिनिट्स मध्ये डिस्कस करूयात, देन वी विल स्टॉप फॉर टुडे सेशन. मेल गॅमेट्स आर फ्लॅजिलेटेड इन. फ्लॅजिलेटेड मीन्स दे आर हॅव्हिंग अ फ्लॅजेला फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ लोकोमोशन. सो मेल गॅमेट्स आर फ्लॅजिलेटेड इन. ऑप्शन्स आर इक्टोकार्पस, पायरोगायरा, पॉलिसायफोनिया अँड अनाबेना. सो विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग shows a flagella? Yes, Zia, if pyrogyra is showing flagella, if pyrogyra is moving through the, that male gametes are transferred through the flagella. Okay, rest of the members. So is it correct? Is this option is correct? Because if you see the mode of reproduction in the spirogyra, spirogyra produces non-flagellated male gametes as they are reproducing through the conjugation. Means this option it is wrong. What about polysiphonia? So polysiphonia produces the male gametes. So again, the polysiphonias are there. B option is wrong, Ganesh, because it does not having a flagellated structure. It is without flagella. Same about the polysiphonia. In case of anabina, anabina is again a non-flagellated structure. So the correct answer of this question is ectocarpus. What is the correct answer for it? Right, A is correct, and it is ectocarpus having a biflagellated male gametes for movement, right? So the correct answer for question number 16 is option A. Okay, then next one, moving to the next question. It is about the kara. It's not a tara, it's a kara, it's algae. Which of the following is wrong about kara? Upper oogonium and lower round anthridium. It is about the reproductive part. For that you have to observe the diagram of kara. Second one, globule and nucule. Globule is the male reproductive part and nucule is the female reproductive part. Globule and nucule present on the same plant. Upper anthridium and lower oogonium. Globule is the male reproductive structure. So out of which is the wrong statement? Yatla tar ek mi sangitlela ahe. C. D option is correct, as globule is a male reproductive part. So A, B, C. Out of which is this wrong statement? Why, Dia, can you explain me? Yes, can you explain me? Other student, what will be your answer for this question? Yes. So let me tell you the answer. The option C, it is the wrong statement. Okay, upper part is not anthridium, that is the part which is the nucule, and lower it is globule. So it is opposite, that's why that option is wrong. Upper side, upper part is always the female reproductive part, that is the nucule, and lower one it is globule. So that's why option C is wrong. Okay, rest three statements are correct. Now moving to the next question. Which of the following is responsible for pit formation? Pit means bog moss. Okay. What is exactly pit? Pit means see which of the following is responsible for pit formation? Question number 18. Pit means what? See, it one of the bryophytic plant. It is there. See, rest whatever the four options are there. That is the bryophytic plant only. But yatla asa ekas correct option ahe. That moss or that bryophytic plant is responsible formation of pit. So the particular plant it is there. The old portion of that plant it undergoes death, but it does not decompose. Okay, ha char paiki asa ek plant ahe ki it becomes old, it undergoes the death, but they do not decompose. Decompose hot nahi, they are secreting the acid. That acid, they are containing antibacterial and antifungal action, which remains accumulate year after year. It remains as it is year after year, and due to it, it form a compact dark colored mass, which is rich in carbon. Where we are using this pit, it is used as a fuel. Okay, fuel म्हणून त्याचा use केला जातो. It is industrial means it has wide application in the industry. So which of the following plant is responsible for pit formation? Means थोडक्यात जसं खत असतं तसंच त्या format मध्ये pit it is formed which is rich in carbon. Merkantia, Rickettsia, Funaria and Sphagnum. That is said to be a pit moss or bog moss. Any idea about this plant? Already I got the answer from Zia. That is the correct. Sphagnum is said to be a pit moss. From that, a dark colored powder-like structure which is formed, which is rich in the carbon, which is used in the many industry. Okay? So the answer is D, sphagnum. Now, second last question. Male gametophyte with least number of cells is present in. Yes, male gametophyte with least number of cell is present in Pteris, Funaria, Lilium, Pinus. Yes. Option D. Okay. So C, let me tell you, your answer is between B and C. It's not A and D. Okay. So male gametophyte with least number of cell is present in. Right, so it is a Lilium. The less number of male gametophyte is present in the Lilium. Lilium is an angiospermic plant, and in angiosperm, a less number of male gametophytes are present. Okay. Now the last question. Select the wrong statement. This will be your homework. Okay, take a snapshot of it, and send me the answer of it on the group. Okay, we'll stop for today's session. Thank you all of you for the joining. Take a screenshot of it and send me the answer on the group. Okay. Thank you, love you.